say in such a short time.
Hard to pick the four lines to wrap it in the packages delivered at your door sign.
Like, of course things have changed,
no matter how hard you grip the details,
but I'ma keep it major
so that the bigger picture prevails.
Brian got jumped, so now you're smoking again.
Quit quitting when the anger turned into the new depression.
And Molly's up in college,
kinda hard to believe.
And mom and pops are doing great, you see them every 2 weeks.
You're still with Susie, living a one bedroom in Brooklyn.
You do the cleaning while she does the cooking.
You got a dog and a cat to a whole little family that makes home something fun that you can come back to.
And the crew's thinned out a bit, not from lack of love, but you've always talked the big one, now it's time to back it up.
So here we are, a quarter century's test,
and for the first time in your life, you can say you did your best now.
Would you last well, bouncing through bars? Take a deep breath of the paint, the smog, the clouds and exhaust. So keep the chain swinging, bat against your palm. Take the road less compatible, then cram it in a song. Cause they're not gonna pay, stay rocking pockets of change. But no when to call the game, cause bathroom floors are all the same. And it ain't glamorous to play this ain't the sinner and the Lazarus. Sometimes leave that passion in the kitchen drawer where the matches is. Your friends will die and take their lives and overdose. And when you see a dysfunctional family once a year, just hold them close. Cause you're a fighter. At least you still say that in your head. And yes, sentence, you guessed it. You still stress to pay the rent, but it's all peace. You packed up your girl and moved out east. And every day you either write or work on 4 hours of sleep. You've been all over the country making music with your friends. So keep doing what you're doing, cause I'll do it all again.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Hey man, we get ready to get started on the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America, the 10 a.m. radio broadcast tonight, men to men talk back, the talk up show every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and we get ready to get started in just a bit. So we want you to best enjoy tonight and call us up if you have comments, or you can use the message board and share your comments, your thought on the conversation tonight. But we're going to be rocking in just a few minutes. Give us about 10 seconds and we're getting ready to hit it. All right. Brothers and sisters, come on. Let's give a warm welcome to our co-host. Amen. Hallelujah. Our co-host tonight is Pastor Karl Young. Good evening, sir.
Amen. 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 Once again, just another day that the Lord has made. Amen. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Amen. Every day that we wake up, amen, and we start to rejoice, it just shows God how much we really appreciate him. And I'm just happy to be on the air tonight, just wait to see what the Lord is going to do, amen.
Amen, amen. I tell you, yes, that's right, Pastor. We got to rejoice regardless of what's going on in America, what's going on in our life. Let everything that has breath praise who? Ye the Lord. Amen. Tonight,
amen.
Tonight, our topic tonight, brothers and sisters, those that are on the conference line, I want to say God bless you. Welcome to another episode of Men to Men Talk Back, the talk up show every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I want to ask everyone if you would share this broadcast on your Facebook page, your Instagram, or any social media. You can actually click on the link if you're listening to this broadcast on the radio. You can copy and paste the link and email it to someone, one of your family members, your friends, and let them know that we're here every week at 9 o'clock, and we have different things that we discuss, we talk, and we welcome you to join us and tell them they are welcome. And also, we welcome our guests that are on the line to leave their or share their comments at the end of the broadcast, because we believe that everybody's response is valuable to us. And your response might just help somebody else call in and want to say a little bit too. So we all helping each other, and we thank again our co-host tonight, Pastor Karl Young, my brother, my friend. Tonight our topic is the heartless heart. Where is the love? Where is love at? You know, we see there's a lot going on around America in the last few days. We've seen some wild things dealing with our children. But before we go into our conversation tonight, we want to make way for our prayer. If Pastor Karl would give us a word of prayer, amen, before we get started.
Father God, we are grateful and we are thankful, Lord God. And Lord God, we repent right now for anything we've said or done that was not pleasing to you. And now, Lord God, we ask that your presence come down and rest with us, Lord God. Father God, we ask that you get the glory out of this show, Lord God. Let me and Pastor Nino decrease right now in the name of Jesus so that there be increase, Lord God. Let everything done on this show, Father God, be of you and not of man, Lord God. Let your people receive, Lord God, right now what you are saying in this time, Lord God, this day, Lord God, this hour, Lord God. Father God, just thank you today, Father God, to be able to even pick up the phone and come and commune with each other, Lord God. And Lord God, we just thank you today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Pastor, for that opening prayer this morning, this evening. Amen. And I tell you, before we get started, brothers and sisters, I want to tell y'all before we get in this conversation that your brother right here is full to the brim. I'm so full, it don't make any sense. I'm going to give a shout out because there's two pastors, two sisters. Amen. One apostle, one pastor at their restaurant. They have a family restaurant in Henderson. And when I tell y'all that food is good, man, you talking about some soul food, y'all. I want to shout them out because I did give them the information to hopefully they're listening tonight. And they didn't know I was going to shout them out. I just told them to listen to the radio show. We're looking for more listeners around the local area. But I'm trying to tell you right now, the name of the restaurant is A Taste of Soul. And you take 39... go across 85 highway, and it's about 4 miles or 5 miles from that bridge once you pass through that crossover, the 85 bridge highway. Stand on 39. The only turn you're going to make is turning into that restaurant parking lot. But I'm trying to tell you, from fried chicken to fried pork chops, baked pork chop, baked chicken, chicken and gravy. They have ribs, they have homemade macaroni and cheese with the burnt on the top. You know how it's brown on the top, man, that homemade fat back meat, candy yams, string beans, peas. I mean, just a mess of food. And they got a honey bun cake that'll make you smack the taste out of somebody. I just want to shout them out because they're wonderful women of God at one. And you, when you go there, you feel a good vibe, a good, you know, welcoming spirit. And they cook everything 100% homemade. So that's A Taste of Soul. Now you can look them up on Facebook and look at them dishes on Facebook, A Taste of Soul. And then on Sunday, they don't open until 1 o'clock. So they open at 1 o'clock on Sunday. And I'm going to tell you right now, if you hit it just right, you're going to be all right. But if you wait, they're going to have a crowd. But I'm telling you, I'm filled up. I'm full. I got itis. So I'm going to try to go on and get this show done so I can sit back in my chair because my stomach swole up. I almost need two stomachs, Pastor. But it's good, brother. It's good. But all right. I just want to shout them out. They're wonderful women of God, and they have a wonderful business. And like I said, I invited them to tune in, and I didn't tell them that I was going to do any of them shouting them out. But this is our second time going, you know, and we just want to try to support our people. Amen. But tonight, man, y'all, the topic, I mean, it speaks for itself. The heartless heart. Where is love? Where is the love at that we supposed to have in our society? You know, we see so much going on, brothers and sisters. I'm just so agitated when I hear these babies crying and being separated at the border. And y'all know it's been all over social media. I mean, it's just been the talk for the last 3 or 4 days. And that these babies are traumatized because you got military grade assault rifles coming into their homes and, or taking their fathers and the kids are crying because they don't know what's going on. It used to be a time where you wanted to have some type of decency in front of the children. But we've seen that they don't care about the children. We've seen where a brother, a law-abiding citizen, just I think last year, law-abiding citizen, got pulled over and got killed by an officer, and the daughter was in the back seat. And so we don't have no respect for life or humans or children anymore. It's just gone haywire. And so we looking at this here, and I want to just speak on the things that's been progressing with this children's separation from their parents over crossing the border of Mexico. But here we see in the article that the president's executive order, it seeks to replace, but it don't fix it, but it replaces it to almost the same thing. It says that the president's executive order seeks to replace one form of child abuse with another. Instead of protecting traumatized children, the president has directed his attorney general to pave the way for the long-term incarceration of families in prison-like condition. So he said he's gonna separate them, but he's gonna put them all in jail together. In other words, just lock them all up together. You know, and kids don't understand why I can't. You know, they don't understand. You know, they don't understand. And it says using terrified small children as leverage to push the president's anti-immigrant agenda. What it does is represent an unspeakably appalling moral low point of our nation, which that is so true on it. Your moral character is questioned, and yet the House representative continued their complicity in the president's anarchies of cravenly cheerleading the president's party policy. And we see this. We see this is what's going on. And then to sum it up about the heartlessness, what we see in America, even with our own neighbors, even here in our own states, we see there's no love and compassion because some people don't even care. Some people have no care of what's going on with their brothers and sisters. It's just like, you know, when I hear about somebody's life being taken in the next town over, I get concerned. I have a compassion for that. But there's sometimes we see people that have no care no more. They heartless. And we're seeing a government and a people that's supposed to represent and supposed to have a duty have no heart to do what they need to do. And not only that, but you know, so many people, pastors, say, well, they are breaking the law. And that's a whole nother issue right there that I can talk about at another time. But the Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, on Thursday, what he tried to do, he tried to quote scripture to make their act right. The Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, on Thursday used a Bible verse to defend his department's policy of prosecuting anyone who crosses the border from Mexico, suggesting that God supports the government in separating immigrant parents from their children. Look at the devil using the tactics of the Bible. And I'm sitting around here, when I was reading about history, these people that we call immigrants, in my understanding of what I read in that history article that's in the dictionary, stated that this is a people, which we call immigrants in America, basically coming back to a land that was stolen from them in the first place. Y'all don't want to talk about that. This stuff is so deep. President Polk, P-O-L-K, I think it is, he went in there because they could not make a deal with them and went in and put armies in there and took the land from Mexico. So basically, they coming back home. And so we keep calling them immigrants, and we talking about laws But the same people that cry with the laws are the same one not even abiding by the laws. That's a whole nother issue right there. But this is such a thing that we see on the news and what's happening with no compassion. You know, I just couldn't see a baby crying for mom and daddy without trying to do something. Amen. What kind of heart do you got? You know, to allow the child be taken away from its parents, and then you sit there and you allow them to be alone. They don't know what's going on. They don't have nothing in store. You just act out of basically they acting with no heart. But here we can see that a poll Monday, and I'm gonna give it to you, Pastor. A poll Monday found 55% of Republicans voters supported family separation. Look at it, 55% Republicans voters supported separation, even though two-thirds of the country doesn't. Two-thirds of the country said, no, wait, we got some compassion. We feel sorry for these folks. It got to take something for a person to go through hell and high water to go to another place. It got to be something so bad that they will risk their lives to try to do something else. It's got to be something. Amen. It's got to be something, y'all. And this is, it's just sickening. But you know, I'm so glad that we see people all standing together, but we're going to get back to the heartlessness. But American Airlines asked the federal government this thing here. They asked the federal government on Wednesday to stop using its commercial planes for transporting children who have been separated from their families due to current immigration policy. And the announcement was posted on the American Airlines website. Amen. Which was the latest fallout from Trump's administration's decision to separate parents who have arrived at the southern border illegally. And that same southern border, y'all look it up back in the 1800s, how it was taken from them. Y'all look at that. Down in, I posted it on my page. Y'all go back and read it. Amen. The same border that they saying they're illegal at was the same border centuries ago. What was stole from them. All right, so now they airlines are standing up and they said, no, we don't want to be involved with that. And then also Frontier Airlines also said they don't want to. If they know it, they don't want to, because what they're doing is saying that these officers, these guarded armed officers, are accompanying not with their mom and daddy, but these are who are detaining them. And that just makes it look like we are just scavengers. Just like we just don't have, we are barbaric here in America. That's where when it comes to no heart, we have no compassion, no love. We look barbaric. And they talk about the law. Well, y'all, I tell you, boy, I'm just like heated because they talk about the law, follow the law. And I see people, they talking about they need to follow the law. Well, nobody followed the law in the very beginning when the first settlers came here to America from England and all of those parts in the first place. They won't know. They was immigrants. And so we can talk deep if we want to, but it's just sad that we've become a people that we rather stab somebody in the back than to lift up somebody that's fallen. We don't want to pick up nobody. And that's such a sad thing. The Bible says that the first commandment of all, hear ye, O Israel, that Lord is our God, is one Lord. And thou shalt love the Lord thy God with what? All thy heart, all thy soul, with all thy mind, with all thy strength. And this is what the first commandment. And then it says, what about, there's one other commandment. The second one. It says, thou shalt what? Love thy neighbor. Well, who is your neighbor? It ain't just the one that's next door. You see the light come on, the porch light come on, or the one in the next town. It's the neighbor all over the world. That's your neighbor. Love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than thee. That's the word of God. Why did he quote that one? Why didn't the Attorney General go to that scripture? To love thy neighbor as thyself. But first we got to love God with all my soul, all my heart. Amen. All my strength, everything I got to love God. Why he ain't quote that? He want to quote something. Why did he quote that? Go ahead, Pastor.
Amen. Amen. I want to make a couple comments, references, before I get into this. Why should we, as a nation, think that he's being in a cage with not bothering certain people? All we got to do is look at the school shoot. Now, we talked about this months ago, me and Pastor, how because of the lack of love and compassion in the land, how kids now, the people just can go into a school and gun down kids, right? But guess what? Since the last time that happened, guess what? Ain't nothing happened. We did all the marches, all the kids, all these went out, they wrote, they went to Congress, but guess what, people, God, ain't nothing happened. So why do we think that they would care about other kids when they don't even care about our own kids getting killed?
You talking good.
Nothing has happened. There's no policies of school being changed. There's no special initiatives that have occurred. There's no bills that went through Congress. Nothing has changed since that incident. When these kids got gunned down. Nothing has changed. So now, but here's the difference. People are getting set up for certain things. And the one thing that will always draw people's compassion and people's love will almost melt their heart is when they see young children suffering. See, when you start seeing babies suffering, babies in cages, babies crying, that moves people. They underestimated that. See, that cry became so loud in the land, and you made some references too, Pastor, about how even the airline said, you know what, this is not right.
Right.
Even our hearts. See, your heart. See, that love that people have, sometimes it has to get revived.
Right.
You see what I'm saying, Pastor? It has to get revived. So when they see kids crying out, babies, they got babies there away from their parents. Babies, 3, 4, 5, 6, that will pull. If you got any compassion in your heart for the love of God, that will bring it out. And I think they underestimated that. And that right there was the turning point. See, they thought that they could just play booty ball with that to get what I want. I could just play booty ball and get what I want. But when they start, you notice they start showing the babies a lot more. Because they begin to see the outcry. And
right.
The outcry was, people just couldn't, they just said, you know what? It don't matter what side I'm on, Democrat or Republican, this is not right.
Amen.
The love in me, see that people said the love that's deep down inside of me, that if someone was hard and hard, even they had to come around. See, even they had to come around. So I think
right.
Love will always trump anything.
That's right.
See, love, when love is in the forefront, love will conquer all. See, love will conquer all. See, the enemy is designed in this season to make sure that the love of God is not in the land. And the love of God is really limited in the land right now.
Right.
It's really limited in the land right now. But even though, you said, Pastor, that they changed that law, it still ain't enough. In my opinion, it's still enough that you still got kids in cage. You still got young kids who have nothing to do with that.
Right.
They have nothing to do. And then you know what? I had somewhat of a vision of that because I was sitting back and I was, meditating on that. And I'm going to say this, and we keep it 100% on here.
Go ahead.
If that was a black child in that case, or if that was a white child in that case, you best believe this would have been over 24 hours. That would have been over 24 hours. If it was somebody other than somebody from other our country, if that was a black kid in there, or it was a white kid in there, or you best believe that would have been over quick.
Right.
Tell her that over quick, Pastor. Because, see, they didn't want to impeach. See, that's what I came to grips with. I said, man, what if that was my son in here? Or Pastor Lee, that was your daughter in here.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Or somebody else's child in here. And you seen them away from their parents suffering like that. What would you got? That brought it home for me.
Right.
Why not bring home? But if you envision your child, your 3 or 2 year old child in a cage,
mm-hmm.
away from their parents, crying, just confused, it's not their fault.
Right.
Because, I mean, this is the thing when we lack love. And see, people think that, you know, that everything is just all right. See, this is how we wind it down. See, this is how we wind it down. So we get into the days of Sodom and Gomorrah and the days of Noah. Amen. We get into those days. Now, there are many different reasons how we can get to the days of Sodom and Gomorrah. But one of the days is, like you said, when we lose our morals.
Right. Now, no more.
When morals become somewhat evaporated, when love becomes evaporated. See, when you take love out of the equation, when you take morals out of the equation, guess what? The devil can move.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's why just that was the number one commandment that you read.
Yes, sir.
The first commandment is, hear ye, O Israel, love our God, love our God. The Lord our God is one Lord.
Yes.
And love the Lord God with all thy heart.
Yes.
He's love. You know why? Because he is love.
Mm-hmm.
He is love, Pastor. Without him, this is what happens. We have put them so far out of the lane that, what's this? Oh, my goodness.
Come on.
Love is limited. Love is limited. So when you have a limited love, this is what you get. This is what you get. Satan knows that if he can remove love out the land, it's more freedom for him to move. As long as there's love in the land, that's a weapon. Love is a weapon, Pastor. Love is a weapon.
That's it.
But I just love you. And see, that's why no matter what nobody do to me or say to me, Pastor, I still pray for you. You know what? I still love you. I still love you. You still got to love.
Amen.
You have a good point about love your neighbor. Your neighbor ain't just next door.
That's it. That's
your
right.
Your neighbor ain't just next door.
That's right.
Anywhere you go and you mention somebody is your neighbor.
That's it. That's it.
When you go to the mall and you're standing in the line with somebody, that's your neighbor.
That's your neighbor.
If you're riding on the bus with somebody, that's your neighbor.
That's it.
If you're sitting at the movies with people, that's your neighbor.
See,
we talk to the thing that's really, really, really bad with us. And this is what the lack of love really does. The lack of love divides. The lack of love divides, Pastor.
Right.
Because the one thing that everybody on this planet can do is love somebody.
That's it.
I might not be able to jump as high as you.
Right.
I might not be able to run as fast as you. I might not be able to be as smart as you. But one thing I know I can do, and we all can do, because we all do it, is we can love somebody.
Amen.
We can everybody love people like their neighbor. This is everybody love somebody else like it was their child.
Mm-hmm.
That is the love of God, because God's love is unlimited.
That's it.
The people who God has really sent after, it's because of love we felt. That's what breaks it down. I'm like, why you love me?
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a filthy rag.
Right, uh-huh.
But you still love me. That's the greatest example. So I will give my son to God for you. That's how much I love y'all. And I don't want y'all to perish.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm holding the horns back to blow. So I'm giving everybody a chance to find love and to get right. Because once you understand God, you will know the true meaning of love.
Mm-hmm.
I thought I loved my sons when I was right there for both of them. I had the honor of actually really pulling them out, and I was the first voice they heard, and I cut both of their umbilical cords. I was right there. I seen their head coming out. It was exciting to me. I thought I could never love nothing like that until I met Jesus. When I met Jesus, that took love to a whole other level, Pastor.
Right.
That love broke addiction. See, that's what they say, just give love. conscious. We live in a world today where it seems like there's no time for love. I don't got time to love. I don't got time. Everything's moving so fast, Pastor. You're trying to make ends meet. Technology is the answer. You got world problems. You got hatred. You got racism. We have let all those things consume our lives and take the place of where love is supposed to be.
Right.
Love now is I can just get on Facebook to be who I want to be. Love now is I can just touch up a button and I can see have a live chat with some X-rated girl and she'll pretend that she loves me and that's good enough for me. Love now is I can get on Snapchat and everything and pretend I got love with false friends.
Mm.
See, we have substituted those things for love, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
For love.
That's it.
And for love. We have begin to live through the flesh. See, we have begin to live through fleshly pleasures. Watch this. We have begin to live through fleshly pleasures instead of our hearts.
Mm.
See, we don't want to go by what's in our hearts.
Right.
We might get ridiculed, Pastor.
Uh-huh.
I might be a nice guy to show love to somebody, but the world now is they think it's corny when you do stuff like that. They think it's corny when you hold the door open for a woman.
Right.
They think it's corny, you know, to help an old lady across the street. They think it's corny to do stuff like that. That stuff is not popular. Being on YouTube, going on world stars, doing shit to somebody or fighting
right.
somebody. Uh-huh. That's what they want to see. We want to see acts of violence. We want to see that we have dismissed love.
Mm.
We have dismissed love, Pastor. The world not love. Amen. Sometimes I see and hear things and wonder as a nation and as a people, do we need to know how to love anymore, Pastor?
That's a good question.
I told y'all about that little event that I had about with some young lady. She was like 22 years old. And she was so angry at life that she just used any excuse and just started cussing me out. Oh, you blah, 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 you stupid, and calling me all things. She was just evil. She was so angry and upset. When you get that upset with life, to where you just cussing people out, I heard her getting out the car, cussing the friend out in the car. So I knew she was off. See, that is the lack of love. when you lack love like that, you allow that hatred, you allow that pain to consume you. That's another reason why it is so important for us to love.
That's
because
it.
When you don't love, something else is going to take its place, Pastor.
Yeah, hate going to take
you
its place.
What?
Hate
when
gonna,
you
that's
don't
it.
Love, something else is taking that place.
Hate will take up
the
that place.
The definition of love. The definition of love. I might get a picture off, Pastor.
No, you good.
You have something to say?
No, you good. I said that okay. Hate. Yes, sir. That hate will come in when you don't have love. Hate will come in, and envy will come in, strife will come in, you know, all of these things, and you bring on so many spirits when you don't have love. The Bible says that love covers what? A multitude of what? Sin. And so when you ain't no love, you will harm your neighbor. You will do these acts in which we see to our children, or because just because they are of another origin, another language, and another culture, that they should be all our children, like our own children. Amen. So yeah, when you don't have love, something else do creep in, Pastor. All right, go ahead, sir.
I want to get down to you read I want to skip down to 33, where it says, "If to love him with all your heart and with all your understanding and with all your soul and with all your strength, and to love thy neighbor is as yourself is more than a whole burnt offering and sacrifices."
Mm, mm, mm.
It's sacrifices.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. See, we will try to sacrifice and do other things besides love somebody. So I'll do something to sacrifice love so I won't have to love it, Pastor.
Mm-hmm.
See, some people bump stuff. It's like, okay, you know what I'm saying? I'll go to church and I'll give $100 offering. You know what I'm saying? To think that that's going to substitute because I don't love my husband no more.
Uh-huh.
Or I don't love my neighbor. Or I don't love people who I work with.
Mm.
So now I'm going to try to do stuff and do sacrifices, Pastor, and try to do things that I think is pleasing to God instead of loving.
Uh-huh.
Instead of loving, the people say, you know, loving people is better than burnt offerings and sacrifices. Mm.
Mm-hmm.
It means more.
That's right. That's
it
right.
It means more.
You got more weight.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, God offered, when he said that, which is thee way. Thou art not far from the kingdom of God. Jesus said, when you love your body and put God first, thou art not far from the kingdom of God. And why does he say they're not far? Because God is love. So when you love people, you draw in. When you got that love in your heart, Pastor, you draw in closer to God.
Right.
When you really love, you begin to draw towards God because he is love. It's like a magnet. You draw towards another magnet. So when you begin to love, oh, come on. When you begin to love, it's like a magnet. You draw towards God because he sees the love, how loving you are. So he'll draw to you.
Right.
Pastor, that's why it's better than that, than sacrifices. And, but here's one of the big things, and I'm going to turn it over to you, Pastor. One of the big things we do is we put limits on love or who we love.
That's so good.
I can love this person, Pastor.
That's good. And sisters, when you do something, you know, with no agenda, you're not looking for a reward, you're not looking for a blessing, you in your heart, you say, okay, I know it's right for me to do this. And you just feel so good because you see now that their whole countenance, their whole expression has changed. You know, they came from a gloom look, an unhappy look, and a sad situation look, to now they got hope. Amen. They now got a smile or a different look about themselves. Like, there's some people that's really still out here. You know, it probably, you know, because there's some people that say, you know what, ain't no good people out here. And then you walk their way and you done bless them. And right when they were giving up on people, sending you to them and you bless them. And now they saying, when I thought there weren't no more good people in the world, the Lord shall bless me. And then he get the praise, even though they might not be saved, they still recognize God. They still would do it, I'm telling you. But it just makes us feel good to be able to help and to give. Amen. And doing it in a meaningful, humble way. You know, when people bless me, you know, it just makes me, you know, I don't care how big or how small, man, it just does something to my spirit. And you know, I don't be looking, but like when people sow into this radio ministry, man, you know, it just makes my heart glad to see those that will just show a little monetary love to the radio broadcast. And I ain't look for, I mean, you know, because I don't get on here like every time and talk about, you know, when you sow into this ministry. I do it periodically, time to time, you know, some, you know, but I thank people that do that. And that's love, you know, that's that love they show on the show. Amen. This radio broadcast. And that's what we do for each other. But, you know, you made some great points in passing. I want to back up a minute. You said that there are some people that don't know how to love. And you know what? And not only that, but let me add to it. There are some people that don't know how to say I'm sorry. You see, the pastor was talking about the young lady was getting out the car cussing and acting all crazy. Well, you know, there are some people, they don't know how to say I'm sorry. But what they would do, instead of them saying, forgive me, I'm sorry, they think that if they can buy you something, if they can just, okay, I know I messed up, I ain't going to say I'm sorry, I'm just going to buy something, or I'm just going to take out to get an outfit, or I'm just going to do something. I ain't going to say these small words. I made a mistake, I'm sorry. But before some people can't say I'm sorry. Some people can't say I messed up. And I'm glad that I'm not a person of that. Because, you know, if I done something to somebody, I want to tell them, hey, man, I'm sorry, man. You know, I'm sorry. You know, you know what? It releases that staleness on the inside that gonna creep up when you don't go up there and apologize for things. And that's love. You know, love will make you go and say, try to make it right, even though you didn't do anything at times. You know what I'm saying? At times, you know you ain't did nothing. You're like, well, you know what? I know I ain't did nothing, but I'm still just, because of my heart, I just got this, you know what, I'm going to reach out. And then, you know, you keep on going, because that helps your spirit. That helps your spirit, you know. So we got to what we see here in society is love. And the church, and I know we ain't talking about the church tonight, but the church ain't no different than what we see on TV about no love at times. We don't, and I'm telling you, we're supposed to be the example of the world. We're supposed to be the example. But what we do, because you might know one more scripture than me, you think you better than me, or Pastor Carl. You think that because you can sway a crowd, or you can get 100 amens, that you better than somebody. Or you think you got this going on, and then you want to crush, that's love too. That's part of the love too, Pastor. That's all in this category too, because one that really love ain't going to talk and bash your stuff. Ain't going to do it. I ain't going to go around here and kick your stuff to the curb and say, they ain't doing that. Pastor ain't doing that. Pastor Carl ain't doing a thing. Why? If I got love for you, I ain't gonna say nothing negative about that. If anything, I'm going to do what I can to lift you up. But we see even down to people think they got assigned seats in church now. They get blown out of proportion because somebody done sat in their seat, and they be sitting in that same seat for years. And they feel like now they own a seat. Now they got no love because now they can't stand the person. Or if somebody else sing one or two more solos than them, they going to get upset. What you doing it for? See, there ain't no love, because you ought to be happy, amen, that for whoever can do something besides you. But some people think that everything rain, shine, and snow on them, everything do on them. And that's a part of not having true love. You know, and also, you know, when people come in and they, like they really, like I said, they really hurt. And I was talking to about this, you know, we talking about, you know, there are times, Pastor, see, the Spirit gave you the utterance and gave you the notion to do what? Help that sister in distress and in a need. Amen. But there's times that the Spirit might not nudge you, But when you keep getting nudged by the spirit, you better go act on it. You got to act on it. But there's sometime, then I told a brother this the other day, you know, a young brother, you know, just gave his life to Christ, you know, recently. I said, you got to be a good discerner. And that's only come with time and relationship with God and discernment, you know. And all of us continue to grow at it. But, you know, there's sometimes that the Lord wanted put in my spirit to give some money. But guess what? He still get me to help. Now, because if somebody come up and they say, bro, can I get $3 from you, $4? Can I get a couple dollars from you? I say, well, are you hungry? You want something to eat? And this is the thing you can do. They say, you want something to eat? And if they say yes, okay, I'm going to go buy some food for them. Come on, let's go eat. Come on, let me get you something. And if they don't want to come in, because some places they don't allow them to come in, I say, tell you what, I'll get what you want and bring it back to you. That's still showing love, ain't it? But then there's some time that the Spirit tell me to go ahead and give the money. Amen. But that's part of it. It's still showing love. But you know, some people have stopped the love, as we see. And when we read some of these post comments, it just you know what? It just breaks my heart to read heartless people and these same people gotta, you know, forget just for that moment that could have been their child. All of these folk that you say, they don't have no remorse. They don't have no care. Lock them up. They say, well, only thing they say, well, they breaking the law. That's what they say. These babies, they don't even know what the law is. You mean to tell these babies? So you going to, so what if it was your child? But you made a good point, Pastor. These same people don't care about them children, nor the children over here, because we still having mass shootings. Matter of fact, like you said, after all of the marches, after all of the signs, posting signs and making all these billboards and all this stuff that they did, all of the everybody, and even the artists, the music entertainers, and everybody coming in. And this one young girl was an activist for it all, and she was on some of these talk shows and all of this. And what has changed? See, now, I told y'all in the beginning, and I know this is not part of the love, but I told y'all that the movement of marching and protesting with signs and going down to the White House or wherever, House of Representatives, wherever you want to go, you can hang out all day long on picket yourself to death on the highway. They still doing what they want to do. The government still doing what they want to do. How many times we done seen them march over the last few years? What's changed? See, the devil know and the evil spirit of the people know that you're going to still spend your money. Now, when you stop the money, when they stop buying these Xboxes and stop buying these PlayStation 2s and PlayStation 4s and people stop supporting the Nike and Jordan, and when they stop spending their money, now they're going to put some on the table. But as long as your money still spending in these facilities, they don't care. You can pick it till the cows come home. You can, and because they ain't got no love for that. They, for the love of money is the what root of all evil. So they love that money. So they don't care about making no bills to protect your children. And the thing about it, these same folk that sitting around talking about they breaking the law is the same folk that your children going to school and don't know the dangers with lies. But my whole thing in saying all of this is when we get back, brothers and sisters, and put God back first in our lives, in not only in our own lives, but when we put God back in the community, God back in the schoolhouse, God back teaching our children God. Amen. Teaching them to love God at the same time teaching them to fear God. Amen. And when we get back to that, amen, when we get back promoting God, then we will start to see the real change in America, in this region, in this nation. We will start seeing this, people. Amen. When we unite, if we're believers, every white, black, every green, blue, red, yellow, every believer that God is God, come together and say, you know what? We're going to boycott everything in America. We ain't gonna buy another dish. Matter of fact, we're gonna get all our cell phone cut off. We're gonna just go dark. And then you're gonna start seeing some change. If y'all would move, do a movement like that, amen. We do a movement like that, that's unity. That's showing the power of the people. And which the power of the people is in the people, but we ain't got no power because we ain't really doing it right. Because we still got a lot of work to do. We still have this light in ministries, in the body of Christ. You know, ministry don't want to hook up, and you know, and that's a whole nother thing. We're gonna be talking about that probably on the next broadcast about the different bodies with the body of Christ and how we are so distant. But I'm gonna tell you, man, love, and you know, love won't allow me to hurt Pastor Karl. Look, my love for him won't allow me to want to see him fall down and laugh at him. Want to speak stuff in the atmosphere that's negative. You know, love, true love won't allow me to do that. And if you saying anything else, we all need to do a self check. If we doing anything else but edifying, loving, lifting up, building up, supporting, if we ain't doing none of that, you need to check yourself and go into a place, in a secret place, and call out to God and let him operate on your issue. Because that's what he needs to do. You know, we got enough people, man, here to make a movement, but we ain't got the love. We ain't got the love, Pastor. And like you said, the world has got so busy. We trying to pay for our bills. We done got so busy. We trying to make ends meet. It's all about us. We don't care about nobody else. And it's such a sad thing. It's a sad thing. You know, and we got to do better. We you know what? Matter of fact, and I'm going to get back to you, Pastor. We talked about so many things on this show. We always, when we talk about stuff, we see stuff coming out. If it's not coming out the same time and what we're talking about, it's going to come out the next day or so. And then we'll hook up and say, man, we just talked about this last week. See, y'all might, some of the people listening to this show, they say, they rough. They're a little rough. But this same stuff that we be talking about, y'all won't listen to it. But then they come out with it, and a week later, you say, I heard that somewhere. Yeah, you heard it here on the show. But you don't want to recognize some things because it's too rough. You want something that water down. Pastor, they want stuff that water down. But a lot of times, they hear this stuff like we talking on the side of our neck. And then when they see it on social media, they say, oh, these guys were talking about this last week, last month. They were talking about, yeah, you know. So we got a lot of work to do. We got a lot of work to do in with our own self, you know. And I thank God for the heart that I got. Because, see, them people that's detained, when I heard about it, it broke my heart. You know, it does something to me. And I thank God that I'm created that way, that I don't have a heartlessness. Because when stuff don't bother you, like stuff that should bother you don't bother you, that's dangerous. Go ahead, Pastor.
Amen, Pastor. You pretty much said it all. You know, when it all comes down to it, love.
That's it.
Love, love, love. It all comes down to love. Love is one of the reasons that we not going to hell.
That's
because
it.
We just so love the Lord that he gave his only begotten Son. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. The reason why we still here is because of love.
That's it.
But we can't love each other.
That's
we
it.
People don't even understand that. The visibility got a hold of that. You got a chance to not go to hell because of love. Mm. Because God is love.
That's...
He loved us that much.
Amen.
Amen. But I just thank everybody for coming on the show tonight. Amen. Tentatively now, we got Apostle Rhonda Hatton out of Dorm Celebration Ministries, and Apostle Novella Paragon from Kingsville Eternal Life Ministries out of Fayetteville. Like you heard Pastor Nino said, talking about denominations and different church platforms. This upcoming Wednesday, we're looking for a dynamic show by these two scholars. Amen. But we're asking everybody to tune in, and we thank you for tuning in tonight. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. We definitely gonna hit topics. Some topics we talking about, what all we do is if we share topics, we share this information, we discuss the stuff that basically in your minds, and you don't have enough courage to want to talk about it. But we need to talk about these denominations. We need to, because if you understand where it come from and what it has done, then now we can start to work on what we need to do to fix it. Because it's a big divide, y'all, and you know it is. It's a big divide, you know, and God ain't in division, and we ought to come together, you know, as a body of Christ. If you any man in Christ Jesus, what, you're a new creature, man. So we're new creatures, and we is, you know, Christ, amen, is the body. For then the body has what? People, amen, from all walks of life, from all culture, you know, culture, different ethnic backgrounds and things of that sort. But it's a lot of stuff that we need to talk about, because, you know, a lot of different churches today, a lot of different ideology and a lot of different doctrines that really confusing folk. And the people that are out here, they don't understand, because see, this topic that's coming up, you know, it reminded me of a conversation that happened last year with an unsaved person talking to a pastor, asking him, why is it so many different denominations? If we're supposed to be talking about this one God, and it's one word, and he is that word. Why is we, you know, so separated? Everybody say this, and if you ain't doing it this way, they say you're doing it wrong. See, that's why we need this pastor. That's why we need this pastor. But let me leave you with this scripture. The Bible says in First John 4, beloved, if God so love us, we ought also to love one another, and love won't allow us to put babies behind bars like criminals. Man, that's all I'm going to say. I'm going to let the people that's called in tonight, if you have a comment, if you would like to share your thoughts, I would like for you to do it at this time.
Pastor Nino, Pastor Karl, this is Pastor Angel. All I have to say is you all kept it 100 tonight, talking about love. I mean, it just really touched me. You all kept it 100 tonight. So God bless both of you. And I look forward to Apostle Hotel and Apostle
Novella.
I look forward to them. God bless both of you.
Amen. God bless you, Mother. God bless you, Pastor. Pastor, my mother, Pastor. Amen. God bless you. Good to hear your voice. Good to hear your voice.
Well, I'm always here. I just don't always say something.
I know. I know. You know, we get a lot of that, and, you know, we don't pull no legs and no arms. We you know, because there's sometimes you just want to just relax and enjoy. And we do thank you when you do make your voice presence and make it known that you're here. But I do understand, because there's many that say, you know, I heard you, but they don't leave a message, or I mean make a comment. So we thank you for your comment tonight, Mother Angel, Pastor, and continue to share this broadcast with all of your friends, your network.
I am. I'm doing that too.
Amen. Thank you, and God bless you. Amen. Anyone else on this line tonight that would love to share their thoughts or comments?
No matter what skin color, no matter what religion, no
Amen. You're so right, man. And I've thought about that one little comment that you just made. You know, regardless of how if you are richer than the richest man on earth, down to the poorest man on earth, at the end of the day, we all going into the ground, to the dirt we go, and so we all end up on the same level at the end of our journey here on earth, and that's in the ground. And so ain't no mansions in the ground, ain't no Rolls Royces, no Bentleys, and none of that, no diamonds and all of that stuff. We going back to the dirt. And so I thank you, brother, for your comment, because yes, if you have true love, you love somebody beyond their skin tone and beyond their language. You know, I might not can speak Arabic, but you know what? My brother can shake my hand, I'm gonna shake his. He want to love me up, man, you know. Give me a hug, I can give him a hug back. Same as anyone else in any other country. You know, that's how I am, man. I wish I could learn every language and I could talk with people. But I can't, but I still love them anyway. Amen. Anybody else before we go would like to share a comment? Amen. Listen, I want you guys to tune in every Wednesday night. At 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and for Men to Men Talk Back to Talk of the Show, we thank again our co-host tonight, Pastor Karl Young, and all of you that have tuned in, and those that were on the line, thank you for your comments tonight. And remember that love conquers a multitude of sin. You know, love heals. You know, the broken hearted, the wounded, you know. When people are on the street, and I'm gonna get ready to go, but when people are on the street and you see their shoes turned over and you see they don't have the best of clothes and you put something in their hand, man, it's like they got $1 million. Just that little something. Amen. That little something, it helps. It go a long way. You know, it ain't got to be something much, but just let them know you're thinking about it. And that's what we need to do. That's what we got to continue to do, and if we say we're followers of Christ, that's what we got to continue to do is love, but love in your heart, not just because we're supposed to love, but just do it because it's natural to do it. You see what I'm saying? See, some people, you know, can read the speed limit and say it's 55, and I'm gonna go 55, but you know, some people say, well, I say I'm supposed to love you. But you got to be the love. You got to be love. You got to have it. Amen. You got to have that thing on the inside. Amen. We know that we're supposed to love by what the word is telling us. But not only that, but it's a part of me. Like the word is a part of us. The word is in us. So it's a part of us. And that love, it got to be genuine. Not just because I made you love somebody. You know how your little children. You got my hair, little kids, when they about 3, 4, 5 years old, they get to fighting with their brother and sister, and you say, no, go over there and hug a neck. Go over there and hug his neck. Go over there and give him a kiss. Go over there and hug him. And you make them do it. They might not want to do it because they done had a little argument. But you at least teaching them something. You know what I'm saying? We ain't making you love, but we want you to genuinely love somebody. Amen. This is a good topic tonight, Pastor. I'm telling you, love, man. We got to keep promoting and preaching that love, bruh. Anything you want to say before we go, Pastor?
Amen. Just everybody that can, just keep supporting this show and just keep loving. Amen.
Amen, amen. We want to thank each and every person on this radio broadcast. We're going to continue with the music, and we'll be right back, so stay tuned.
We you say, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Come on, warehouse, lift your voice, say it.
Lord, we thank you.
We thank you.
You are good.
Jesus.
Lord, we praise you.
For all your goodness unto us, O Lord.
You are good.
For your mercy every day.
Lord, we praise you.
We praise you. You are good. Somebody to sing it with me, just say it.
Lord, we love you.
We love you, Jesus.
You are good.
And for everything you've done, we come back to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
You are good.
And we lift our voice and fill the earth with praise.
Don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away.
That's right. That's right. You've heard it best here on Men to Men Talk Back, the talk up show every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where there is the love, love that we love. Amen. Let it be unconditional. Amen. Let it have no limits. Love have no limits. Amen. God loves us even when we mess it, even when we angry, even when we stiff neck, even when we stubborn. God still loves us when we disobedient. But you know, he loves us and he gives us the example. And therefore, we should have the same example to love. Wonderful conversation tonight. The heartless heart, as we see many men and women around this country. And if they replace that with love, they need to have an operation of love in their heart. And we pray that God will allow their heart to be filled with his presence. Because if you have the you have the presence of God in your heart, if you have God's spirit, hallelujah, in your soul, in your body, amen, you filled up with the Holy Ghost, you can't do nothing but love. Amen. You can't do nothing but love. And so you got to kind of, you know, maybe want to do a self-check. You can't, you know, you always got something to say, turn down some folk. You might want to check yourself. You know, I think a lot of time we can check our own selves sometime. And you know, a lot of time it comes with just humbling yourself. Amen. Just humbling yourself and allow God to come in. But, you know, it's a sad thing that we see not only here in this country, in other countries around the world. And we pray that this broadcast continue to go out throughout the world. And I hope that somebody new is listening in tonight. Again, we did shout out a Taste of Soul restaurant out of Henderson. I think there's another little town. I can't think of the name of it. But a Taste of Soul. And if you can look on Facebook, look them up. Look at those dishes, man. And then go there and visit them on Sunday, 1 o'clock. Or 2 o'clock, or 3. Amen. Go down there and tell them try some of that honey bun cake. Tell them that I sent you down there. Amen. They don't know me like that. You know, I remember them, but they don't remember me like that. But we thank God for all of you that tuned in tonight. We just enjoyed the broadcast again, man. Love, man. Love, love, love. We can't say enough about that, you know. And the people that commit these heinous acts of school shootings, school murder, brothers killing brothers in the hood, if they had love, they wouldn't do it. And then if they had people to really love on them, love covers a multitude of sin. If you really had somebody to love on folk, you know, but we done got so out of whack. We done got so out of whack as a people in this land. But we got to continue to do what we got to do. Talk about it, and you're going to hear it on the show. So again, we want to remind you that we have Apostle Hatan that's going to be on, as well as Apostle Patterson, Novella Patterson. They're going to be on next week, and we're going to be talking about denominations. We're going to be talking about a few other things on this show. So Pastor Karl and myself are going to get with them. We're going to make this. Hopefully, I can get my computer. I got my computer. My wife done got me a little something, so I got to try it out. So hopefully, I can start back making flyers, because I really enjoy making the flyers for the show and the events that we have and the people that we have guests that's on the show. So again, we want to... you know, come on next week with a open mind. And those that was on the conference call, I pray that they tune back in and invite a friend. Matter of fact, I pray that everybody that's listening on this broadcast invite 5 people to tune in next week, Wednesday at 9 o'clock. I got over 1,000 friends on Facebook. And I don't have 1,000 people on the line. So I know some people work. But all 1,000 plus ain't working. I think it's about 1,600. And I know everybody ain't working. Sometimes we do give a word, and it might not be swallowable, if you will. But if you somehow can digest it, or really pick what you need, what you know, what the components that you need, you get. And whatever else you don't need, just go on about your way. Amen. But you know, there's always gonna be something in the conversation that you can get that help you along the way. This show is designed to help uplift people around the country and in other countries. This broadcast also lets you know what's going on in the local community, near and far. Also, we have different preachers and teachers on this broadcast. We have a new show, Be Free, from the Inside Out radio show, the hottest show in North Carolina besides the Men to Men Talk Back. Amen. She is on every Monday night at 7:30, Evangelist Antoinette McCormick, and she has given us great teaching, and she showed us she can preach. Amen. But she has a passion for helping God's people. And also Pastor Karl, my co-host here on Men to Men, have a passion to help folk. And as yours truly, I got a passion to help folk. And you got that type of passion, you're going to give them something that they can strive on. You might have to pop their hand a little bit. You might got to give them a little spanking every once in a while. But we're going to say something on here like tonight. Ended up with love. Amen. You know, we got to love. We got to love one another. Amen. We got to love one another. I tell you, we just thank God again for all of you that tuned in tonight. And we pray the blessings of the Lord upon all of your lives. And we'll see you on tomorrow night between 8 and 9 p.m. for Thursday night. Now, before I do go, I want to remind every preacher, every pastor, every apostle, every bishop, every prophet, prophetess, teacher, evangelist. If you have a word from the Lord and you are not on radio, and we would love to have you become part of this radio broadcast that goes out throughout the world. Because one thing about online radio, you never get no static. You can go anywhere. You got an internet connection and get hooked up. See, if you are in Raleigh or Durham or Greensboro or Winston-Salem, you know, anywhere, Charlotte, anywhere in North Carolina, you listen to North Carolina radio stations and you traveling up to D.C. and New York City, you no longer hear them stations anymore. But one thing about this broadcast, everywhere you go, everywhere your phone go, everywhere your tablet go, everywhere your computer go, everywhere you can get an internet connection, a hotspot, you can listen to this broadcast. And not only that, but you can go back and listen to the replay as much as you want. Amen. That's the beauty of this radio broadcast. And that we're so excited about this radio ministry. And we want to welcome anyone that have a word from the Lord, that have a passion to love on people, to love on God's people, to share a word of encouragement, to share a word of deliverance. Join this broadcast. Have your own show within this radio broadcast. And watch God do amazing things. I say it again, I'm going to keep saying it. As we all connect with this broadcast, as it grow, we all grow. And as it go up, we all going up. If we stay connected, we all going to go up. We don't know when it's going to happen, but we know that it can and it will happen, as long as we faint not. You know, I was telling my son today when I was dropping him off at NC State University. I said, son, do you remember back when you was in elementary school? I told you before you get out of high school, we was going to get a new home. And it seemed like it never was going to come. But it's all in God's timing. I told him, I said, one day I'm going to have my own business. And I've been talking that talk for about 20 years. And finally, I have my own business. See, sometimes you can have a desire. You can have some things that you want, but they, you know, it don't come in our timing, but it comes in great timing. Amen. And that's when God opened those doors up. And I said, you see all the things that I told you, it don't happen immediately all the time. Some things come in a process. And just as I'm saying that to my son, I'm telling you this, that listening on this radio broadcast. You see this broadcast at this stage now, it's been 5 years. Well, going forward, you never know how this broadcast is going to pick up. You never know what millionaire going to come and lay a million in our hand. And you never know how somebody is going to really, truly bless this broadcast. You never know how it's going to elevate. But I believe it will. And as long as I keep pushing this radio broadcast and connect with those that have the same like spirit, same like mind, and same like passion to deliver the gospel of Jesus Christ to all of the lost and those that are unsaved, amen, that they will be found, and those that will have a connection with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We're going to continue this broadcast. We're going to continue to do what we got to do. The mission still stands, and that was a message I preached maybe a few years ago. Amen. The mission still stands. And talking about men, regardless of what we go through and what we endure, the breakups and the breakdowns and the setbacks and all of the traps that the enemy set up, regardless of what we endure, the mission still stands. And the mission is, hallelujah, to proclaim the gospel throughout all the world. Amen. And we're going to continue to do that in this broadcast, my brothers and sisters. So you've heard the petition tonight. For all of you that desire to be a part of this radio broadcast, you can simply email me at pastorakridge2016@gmail.com. That's pastorakridge2016@gmail.com. And you can look me up on Facebook. Amen. N-I-N-O. And last name is Akridge, A-K-R-I-D-G-E. Or you can also on Facebook, The Minister Akridge Show. You can go to Facebook for Healing Word Ministries. All of these avenues, you can locate me. Amen. You can locate me also on this on our profile page on this radio show. You have my email that I had when I first started this broadcast. It still works. Either way you need to contact me, you contact me. Whether it's through a friend or whether through a person that's already connected with me. Amen. We want you to be a part of something great. Amen. And you know, a lot of times people don't connect with people because of where they started from. Some people connect with folk because of, oh, they got everything seems that's going on good. You know, all of the big cars and the big ministries and all of the chandeliers and all of the thick carpet and all of the widescreen television tubes on in the church and everything, you know, people connect with them, but the ones that continue to press on, hallelujah. See, one day the last gonna be first, and the first gonna be last. One day the last that keep pushing and keep striving and keep marching and keep putting their best foot forward, one day they gonna be first. If they faint not, if we faint not, if we don't give up too quick. See, sometimes it don't happen quick enough. Some people say, man, they ain't going to do nothing, man. They ain't been talking about the same old thing for a while. Well, that's the hope that we got. We're going to keep doing it until God releases it, until God make a breakthrough, until God sends somebody our way to put a check in our hand and let us become a full 24-hour radio station. We're going to do what we got to do. And we're going to keep doing it the way we're doing it now until God sends such a person. And it could happen. And then right when you doubted, right when you gave up, the blessing came. And you done gave up, and then we kept going. The train was moving. It was moving at a pace you could climb on. But when it get moving to a speed you can't climb on, it'd be too late. Amen, somebody. Listen, God bless each and every one of you again for tuning in. Meet us back here next Wednesday night at 9 o'clock. Remember to invite 5 people. Amen. Everybody that listened to it live and everybody that listened to the replay, I want you to invite 5 people to listen to this radio broadcast next week. I mean, you got leaders in your church, invite them to tune in next week. We're going to get down to it. I'm going to let them talk and I'm going to say my spin on what I feel about the conversation on next week. Because you've already heard me preach this on this show years and years ago, This is what why the Lord has taken me out of a place and putting me in a new place. And this is what he does when he wants you to see things clearly. You know, when we look at that Bible, you got to give me Bible. You got to give me Bible book, chapter and verse, where you feel that we should have all that we got, what we're getting ready to talk about next week. Where it at? You show it to me and read it to me. Make it plain where we should have denominations. I know I read my Bible, and I don't know what Bible you read, but there was people. And there were people that was rebellious, that were wicked people. And then there were people that when they did what God wanted them to do, when they did right, they got blessings. God looked out for them. When they was wicked people, had wicked deeds, did wicked stuff, they were consumed. Those that love God, fear God, trusted God, these was a blessed people. Amen. They ain't with two people. Either evil, you with God, or you're against him. And all the other stuff we got today, where did it come from? Where did it start? Where did all of these different things start? And why were they started? And my belief is that somebody was upset with somebody and started to go over here. Some went over there. I want to do it my way. I want to do it my way. And everybody's doing different things. But we'll talk about that on next week. I'm so excited, I can't even wait. But I want to press fast forward to next Wednesday night at 9 right now. But anyway, y'all better tune in because it's going to be hot. All right? God bless you. I love you. Amen. This next song is one of our brothers from Atlanta, Georgia, the ATL, Brother Robinson, with his first CD, Disciples. Amen. We're playing it all here on the Timmy Radio broadcast. You've been listening to Men to Men Talk Back, the Talk Up Show. And I'm your host, Pastor Nino Akridge, and co-host, Pastor Karl Young. God bless you, and have a wonderful evening.
Can't be ashamed, yeah. I live that Christian lifestyle. I can't wait a while, I gotta live it right now. Covered in the blood of Jesus, gonna wipe me down. I'm too fresh, gonna wipe me down. I live like a disciple now. Everlasting high, God be saying Jesus loud. Because the enemy trying to wipe us out. Blood of Jesus gotta clean us now. Glorious, so matchless. It's the Lord, he attached to us. We can't fully understand his love. For this world, his life, he gave it up. The face of Father God, he make it up. Made in his image on that mountain, he was glowing up. Transfigurated, James and John was stuck. Peter spoke by tabernacles, yup. Have all of me suffice eternal life. My life is not my own, cause I'm a living sacrifice. Superman, but ain't no kryptonite. Invincible with Jesus' blood, I consist the light. Light of the world, the salt of the world. Can't lose the savior, preach the gospel with a flame, yup. Avoiding fame, cause I was made from dust. Born in the spirit, kill the flesh, what's up? I live that Christian lifestyle. I can't wait a while, I gotta live it right now. Covered in the blood of Jesus, gonna wipe me down. I'm too fresh, gonna wipe me down. I live like a disciple now. Everlasting high, got me saying Jesus loud. Because the enemy trying to wipe us out. Blood of Jesus gotta clean us now. Philippians 1:6, I'm confident in the Lord, forget the pence. Not confident cause I got sense. I thank the Lord for common sense. Yeah, that presence ain't why I'm motivated. Righteous indignation, mammon got us walking faithless. Doubt and worryation, loss of patience. Robbers of our faith, we feel forsaken. But we can't feel forsaken nor naked. Jesus said he never leave us nor forsake us. Eyes closed, we gotta awaken. I got the trumpet plus I got a cadence. The word of God, they tryna erase it. Put the Bibles back in school, I rebuke Satan. Knowledge applied to God, you making strides.
on eagle's wings, let's take a ride, yeah. I live that Christian lifestyle. I can't wait a while, I gotta live it right now. Covered in the blood of Jesus, gonna wipe me down. I'm too fresh, gonna wipe me down. I live like a disciple now. Everlasting high, got me saying Jesus loud. Because the enemy trying to wipe us out. Blood of Jesus gotta clean us now. I live that Christian lifestyle. I can't wait a while, I gotta live it right now. Covered in the blood of Jesus, gonna wipe me down. I'm too fresh, gonna wipe me down. I live like a disciple now. Everlasting high, got me saying Jesus loud. Because the enemy trying to wipe us out. Blood of Jesus gotta clean us now.